Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn how to configure Linux kdump and perform VM core root cause analysis. Kernel panic error can occur due to bad memory or driver crashes or malware or software bugs. To identify the cause of the kernel panic, we can use the kdump service to collect the crash dumps and we can perform the root cause analysis based on the troubleshoot of the system. In my case, I am having the CentOS operating system. So let me start the technical discussion. Step 1, we need to install the kdump utility. So for that, we have to use yum install command. So this is the utility kxctools which needs to be installed on the system before starting the kdump configuration. Once installation done, we can see there is a default configuration file for the kdump. So this is the file. We can check it. Once the installation completed, create the directory called kdumpfs crash. So you can create a separate vg or separate under root vg or separate data vg or separate raw disk or nfs drive, and whatever is up to you. So how you want to create the store the kdump configuration. In my case, I am storing the kdump configuration, the system itself. So I have created the directory called kdump crashfs. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to add this entry in the kdump configuration file. Let me take the file and go to the end of the file, and you can replace this line and save it. Once configuration done, you can validate the configuration file. Yeah, we have mentioned the path is the kdump core file will be stored here in this location only. Step number 3, update the default grub configuration file vi/etc default and grub. In this file, we have to add the entry in the grub command line section. So that is called crash kernel equal to 512M, which means the kdump service will reserve the 512MP memory during the panic time. So this memory will be only used for the kdump service. So using this memory, the whatever memory information is available in the system during the issue time, it will dump and store into the destination path as a VM core file. So this memory as a reserved memory, which it cannot be released. Okay, once it is done, now we can validate the configuration file. So this is the line for the kdump service memory we are allocating. So once the configuration is done, we need to regenerate the grub2 configuration file. For that, we have to use the grub2mkconfig file, and this is the output file we need to regenerate. Okay. For the kdump configuration, there are additional few important system parameter which need to be added in the sysctl-conf file. So you can add this line in the sysctl-conf file, which will help to collect the system dumps during the issue times. So you can view this file for your reference. After adding the system parameters, we need to save the settings as a permanent. You can execute the systemctl-p command, and the settings will be saved as a permanent for the next boot. Step number 6. Once the kdump configuration changes has been done, we need to enable the kdump service and need to start the kdump service and validate the status. Yes, we can see now we have successfully configured the kdump service. Now it's time to reboot the system. Let me reboot the system. Yeah, let me take the duplicate session or restart the session. Yes, now system has been successfully rebooted. Now it's time to make the system into the panic state, but do not perform this action in your production system. So here I am going to show you how to make the system panic in manually and how to analyze the VM core file. Okay, And prior to that, we have to validate the how much memory in the system. So currently my system having the 512 MP memory. Suppose if you have the 1 GB memory and make sure this file system, for example, where you want to store the VM core log file, this also must be the same size or at least more than 100 MP extra. So this is the requirement. If you have the 2 GB memory, this file system should be 2 GB size or more than 2 GB. Now it's time to perform the manual panic error. So let me enable the sysrecode, which will help to enable the system into the panic state. So I'm enabling the parameter, the sysrecode settings, the function. Now I'm making the system sync, like sync all the mounted file system. Done. Now it's a time to crash the system. So for that we have to use, you can see the C letter we have to use for the system crash. So now I made the press enter, after that my system into the panic state, and you can see here by copying the data means whatever memory informations are available, which will be storing into the where crash folder, where the destination directory where we need to store or where we need to dump. So now my system getting booted. Post booting the system, we can perform the VM core analysis for the RCA findings. We can see the system has been rebooted now. Let me log into the server using PuTTY. Yeah. Now we can go to this directory and see whether that VM core file gets generated or not. Yeah, we can see there is a folder directory is available. So in this directory, we can see the VM core files. So there are two files are generated. One is a VM core file, another one is a VM core D message text, which means prior to the reboot, what was the output of the D message command. So all the information stored in the text file, we can carry this file and we can see what was the cause for the system panic. And you can see here why the system went to the panic state. And we can see here from the text file, we can see due to the sysrecode, the system went to the panic state. From the text file, we can see why the system getting crashed, and we can see there is a sysrequest function has been triggered, due to which the system went to the panic state. So using the text file also, we can identify the RCA. If you want the more depth about the VM core, and we can perform the VM core analysis. Prior to that, we need to install the two software. Let me display in here. So there is a two software we need to install, that is called the crash utility, that another one utility, it is called the kernel debug info, and make sure both the RPM must be installed in the system. So then only we can able to analyze the VM core file. It is not mandated to install the same system. You can install a different system and you can perform the VM core analysis for the RCA findings. In my case, it is already installed. So now I am going to perform the VM core analysis. To perform the VM core analysis, there is a command called crash we have to use. Then the modules, so the kernel modules where it is available, that path we have to mention. Then our VM core file, VM core file path, or VM core, if you are in the same path you can mention the file name, or if you are in different path you have to mention the full path. So let me execute it and you can wait for the crash output. So you can see here why the system went to the panic state. It is clearly giving that the function has been triggered, due to which the system went to the panic state. For more information, you can run the help command and we can see what are the system states. For example, if you want to see the system logs, you can type log. So or else if you want to check something, if you want to get the system panic, why the system went to the panic state, you can run there is a command called sys and see. So it is clearly giving that the system into the panic state due to sysrec function. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.